I will introduce spectroscopy to you in 5 to 6 lectures before going to the rotational spectroscopy or specific other spectroscopies. Now, what does this term means? This basically means interaction of electromagnetic radiation with matter. Interaction of electromagnetic radiation with matter. And to extract important information regarding the system. For example, with the help of a tape, you cannot measure the length of a bond, of a covalent bond. Now, how will you get it? So, to have the bond length of a molecule, say HCl, you need the help of spectroscopy. What is the mechanism to get it? That I will discuss in the specific chapters. To have the bond length, you have to perform either microwave spectroscopy or infrared spectroscopy. And I will show you how to determine the bond length of a molecule. Also, it will be helpful in case of detecting functional groups accurately so that one can predict the molecule that he or she has generated in the or synthesized in the laboratory. So, in the case of organic synthesis research, it is a very useful tool. And without the help of spectroscopy, this research could not have been done. Now, this interaction of EMR with matter, that needs to be elaborated. So, first we will deal with electromagnetic radiation. We all know that electromagnetic radiation consists of oscillating electric and magnetic fields which are perpendicular to each other and they both are perpendicular to the direction of propagation. So, this is the basic nature of an electromagnetic radiation. Now, it can be represented by the simple wave equation, that is y equals to a sin theta. Theta is the angle executed by the wave. Now, if omega is the angular frequency, that is angle executed per second, then theta can be replaced by omega into t. So, this equation can be written as a sin omega t. This is the variation of displacement of the oscillation of the wave with time in this direction. But it is not the traveling equation. For traveling equation, it will be y equals to a sin kx minus omega t. That I will discuss in the harmonic oscillator section later. Now, in one complete oscillation, angle executed is 2 pi. So, upon executing 2 pi radian, number of oscillation is 1, number of complete oscillation. So, for 1, it will be 1 by 2 pi and for omega, it will be omega by 2 pi. Now, this is the angular velocity, that is angle executed by the wave in 1 second. So, number of complete oscillations that will be executed by the wave in 1 second is omega by 2 pi. So, this is one complete oscillation. This is 0. This is pi by 2. This is pi. It is 3 pi by 2 and here it is 2 pi. And then the pattern repeats So number of such complete patterns that are being executed by a wave in 1 second is omega by 2 pi. So this will be the frequency, which is the number of complete oscillations performed by a wave. Now this is having a unit hertz or second inverse, cycles per second. So we have nu equals to omega by 2 pi or omega equals to 2 pi into frequency. So the equation can be rewritten as y equals to a sine 2 pi nu t. Now for simplicity, for handling the situation in a more easier way, spectroscopists have switched from frequency to wave number. Now what is that wave number? Wave number is the number of waves per centimeter. So in 1 second, distance traveled by an electromagnetic radiation is c centimeter. This is the velocity of electromagnetic radiation, which is 2.998 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, or 2.998 into 10 to the power 10 centimeter per second. So in 1 second, it travels 2.998 into 10 to the power 10 centimeter, which I am referring as c. Now in 1 second, the number of complete oscillations executed by the EMR is nu. So there are nu complete oscillations in 1 second, and it travels c centimeter in 1 second. So from this we can write, in c centimeter there are nu complete waves. So in 1 centimeter there will be nu by c number of waves, which is the wave number nu bar. Nu by c equals to nu bar. So what will be the unit? It is per second, and it is centimeter per second. So it will be 1 by centimeter, centimeter inverse. Now this must be, since the definition is number of waves per centimeter. Now we have y equals to a sine 2 pi nu t. If we wish to replace it, it will be a sine 2 pi c nu bar t. Spectroscopists prefer this wave number instead of frequency or wavelength or energy to represent the position of spectra, just because its magnitude is easy to handle. The electromagnetic spectrum is cosmic, then it's gamma ray. If we have an order, if we try to have the order of energy, we will get cosmic greater than gamma. Now it will be greater than X, greater than ultraviolet, greater than violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red, greater than infrared, greater than far infrared, greater than microwave, greater than radio frequency. So this is the energy order of the electromagnetic radiation spectrum. Now each zone of the spectrum is associated with a particular process of spectroscopy. For example, the radio frequency region that is having the frequency range 3 into 10 to the power 6 to 3 into 10 to the power 10 hertz, that is in the wavelength range 10 meter to 1 centimeter, is responsible for nuclear magnetic resonance and electron spin resonance. And the energy involved in this transfer process, that is reversal of spin of a nucleus or electron, is of the order of 0.0012 10 joules per mole. Now the microwave region, which will have the frequency 3 into 10 to the power 10 to 3 into 10 to the power 12 hertz, and the wavelength range 1 cm to 100 micrometer range. Now this is responsible for the rotational spectroscopy, and the separation of the rotational energy levels is of the order of hundreds of joules per mole. Now note that the boundaries that I am mentioning, that is 10^10 to 10^12 hertz, is not such precise, that is overlapping in the boundary region, but this is for just understanding the domain. Now the next higher energy region is infrared region, which is in the range 3 × 10^12 to 3 × 10^14 hertz, and in the wavelength region 100 micrometer to 1 micrometer, and it is responsible for the vibrational spectroscopy, and it is the one of the most important spectroscopic regions for a chemist. Separation of the energy levels is of the order of 10^4 joules per mole, that is 10K of the order of. Next appears the visible and the ultraviolet regions, which is in the frequency range 10^14 hertz to 10^16 hertz, and in the wavelength we have 1 micrometer to 10^1, that is 10 nanometer range. This is responsible for electronic spectroscopy, and the separation is of the order of kilojoules, some 100 kilojoules per mole. Next, the X-ray region. This is more powerful than the ultraviolet or visible range, and its frequency order is 10^16 hertz to 10^18 hertz, and the wavelength ranges from 10 nanometer to 100 picometer, and the energy change involves the transfer of inner electrons of an atom or a molecule, and its energy is of the order of 10,000 kilojoules per mole. Lastly, we have the gamma region, which is of the order of 3 × 10^18 hertz to 3 × 10^20 hertz, and the wavelength ranges from 100 picometer to 1 picometer. Now the energy that is involved is the rearrangement of nuclear particles. So this gamma ray is so powerful that it can alter the orientation of or the arrangement of nucleons within the nucleus, and it is having the energy order of 10^9 to 10^11 joules per mole. Now cosmic ray has no application, since it is difficult to generate cosmic ray. It is such a powerful ray, and also we have touched all the sectors of an atom or a molecule, from the bond length to the nuclear configuration. So there is no need of cosmic ray regarding molecular spectroscopy. Now in the next video we will learn about the nature of the spectrum.